draw a line of any measurement. Name it as A and B. Now draw any radii. You have to draw a semicircle. How you had done in the 60 degree, the same way now you need to draw an arc. Name this point as D. Now with the same radii you need to draw another arc, and now on this arc I'll name this as E. Now with E as center you need to draw another arc. Name it as F. Don't change the radii. With the same radii, with E as center, draw an arc, and with F as center, draw another arc. Let both the arc meet at a point. Let it be G. Now draw the line. Please don't change the measurement. If you change the measurement here, you will not get this exact 90 degree. You may get more than or less than 90 degree. So please be careful. And now this is another ray. And now you can mark this as angle C. So now you can see angle BAC is equal to 90 degree. Angle BAC is equal to 90 degree. So now 90 degree is constructed. After constructing 90 degree, now you take the measure of this arc. So these two you can see here. So the measure of this arc you can take. Don't take the measure of this arc, okay? So now initially we had taken any radii arc we had taken and we constructed. And now what you have to do, measure the distance from D to this 90 degree. Okay, that is from here to here you are going to measure, and draw an arc here and draw another arc here in such a way that let both the arc meet at a point. You can name this point as P, and now you can draw a line. Just draw a line. So now this is the bisector. Now AP is bisecting angle BAC. So now we will see what is the measure of angle BAP. So that should be exactly 45. Yeah. Yes, you can see it's 40. So this will be 45 and this will be 45. So draw the mark the arcs properly, and this is a point. So through that point the line should